Actually, my testimony is really kind of a mixture of other people's testimonies. When I first started leading the Women's Bible Study for the Women of Hope, I felt God really laid it on my heart that we really should be committed to His Word, and that I didn't want to get into, you know, the books written by this woman or that woman, but I wanted to have us be in God's Word and just be in God's Word and just us, so that it wasn't like me preaching to people either, where they're getting another sermon on Tuesday night, but that we were all sharing with each other what we were seeing in God's Word. And so this is really a testimony about God's faithfulness to that. Actually, I asked Penny last week if I could share this. So she actually came to the Lord, she says, during our Book of John study. And, you know, of course, Penny's sat with us for many a Sunday. And but during her testimony, during her baptism, she shared that she really came to a stronger understanding of who Christ was, what He did for her, and what the gospel really meant during the Women's Bible study. So that, like, was wow. Like, it's just kind of neat to, like, kind of be faithful to just, okay, we're going to study through God's Word, and we're going to do that on purpose. We're just going to, you know, study faithfully through God's Word, and we'll see what He does. Well, we were starting Revelation, and I got an email from, I think, traffic from, not from Facebook, from the website. This woman Googled, and I think Google keeps track of these things, Googled North Kingstown Bible Study. So she, North Kingstown Bible Study and Living Hope Christian Church came up. So she was looking for a women's Bible study, and so she emailed me directly, and she said, I'm a 50-something-year-old Catholic believer. I'm a divorcee. Am I welcome at your Bible study? I said, sure. Of course, I was like, okay, we're studying Revelation. Yeah, I'm like, Lord, do you really think, like, should I, like, maybe divert her and tell her maybe just try the Wednesday night study, or, and he was like, no, just, you know, keep on keeping on. So I was like, okay. So she has been with us for nearly every single Tuesday that she possibly could. Actually, last week she couldn't make it, and she audio chatted with us. June, I just want to listen. So after the first study, she asked us, she said, you know, who are the 144,000? And we found out that her husband had become a Jehovah's Witness and left her because of her faith and his faith were different. And so he left her. But going through the book of Revelation, it became clear who the 144,000 were. We didn't have to, like, preach our position or anything like that. We just went there to chapter 7, I think it is, and we're like, these are who the 144,000 are. Like, we're pretty sure they're not Jehovah's Witnesses. So anyway, after the first study, she said, that is the most of the Bible I have ever heard in my entire life. And we were like, whoa. And she was so hungry, and she is still so hungry. And I'll just share one more thing, was that she was like, I feel like a child. I feel like I don't know anything. I feel like, you know, even Elise and Sarah who were there, she's like, I feel like they even know way more of the Bible than I do. And Sarah said, well, I have these videos called What's in the Bible by Buck Denver. So she took all the videos home, and she was embarrassed to watch them by herself, so she invited the children from her neighborhood and their families to watch them with her. So my testimony is basically really about God's faithfulness to His Word. And, like, to me, I feel like I had to do nothing. I really didn't have to do anything to facilitate this, but just be faithful in this small weekly thing that God has set in my heart to do, and that His Word is going forth and it will not come back void.